Canada's borders remain closed to all non-essential travel, but in recent weeks, there have been reports of Americans finding a way to cross into the country and enjoy a vacation up north. But now, Canada is clamping down on travelers using the so-called Alaska loophole. As of July 31st, Alaska-bound Americans will be given a reasonable amount of time to reach the 49th state and must notify Canada Border Services Agency once they've arrived.
If you're traveling to Alaska and you're an American citizen and you have legitimate travel plans, I do believe you should be checking in and checking out so that you can't make a three-day trip, maybe a three-week vacation. So I agree with that.
Travelers to Alaska may only enter the country through one of just five border crossings: Abbotsford, Kingsgate, or Osoyoos in BC, the Coots Crossing in Alberta, or North Portal in Saskatchewan. Travelers will also be given this hang tag that must stay on the vehicle's rearview mirror for the duration of the trip. On the front, it clearly says in transit to Alaska. On the back, it lists all of the safety measures travelers must follow.
I think it's a recipe for disaster.
U.S. immigration lawyer Len Saunders believes the placard doubles as a target on American drivers. Even if they're following the rules, it creates conflict with curious Canadians.
Going up, trying to see, you know, whether they are violating that loophole and possibly reporting them to the police or taking matters into their own hands.
When it comes to U.S. license plates in Canada, tensions are already running high, with reports of Americans being harassed while in Canada for essential work.
I'm concerned about driving a U.S. plated car in Canada. I hate to say that, but I am.
I can't tell people how to respond when they see an offshore plate. What I can tell those individuals is there's a high degree of certainty in British Columbia that we want to keep our borders closed until neighboring jurisdictions get a better handle on COVID-19.
Canada's borders remain closed to non-essential travel until August 21st, with the closure likely being extended beyond that. The RCMP says so far in BC, six Americans have been fined $1,000 each for violating Canada's Quarantine Act. In Vancouver, Travis Prasad, City News.